Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Mexican-style roasted garbanzo beans. Garbanzo beans are the same as chickpeas, so you could refer to this as roasted chickpeas if you like. The first thing you do is open 3 cans of garbanzo beans, and the cans I have are 15-ounce size cans. You need to drain those thoroughly through a colander and then rinse them thoroughly. And after that, they're going to be wet, of course, so you put them on paper toweling and blot them dry. You try to get them as dry as you possibly can. And you can see a lot of the moisture has come out on this paper towel and the bottom paper towel. Now we're going to try to transfer this, and this is kind of weak because it's wet, but I need to transfer all of this to my baking pan, which I've prepared here by lining it with aluminum foil. So here we go. You want to just spread them out, make an even layer if possible. This is kind of a little bit much to make it just a single layer. This will even it out pretty well. That's good. Now I have my oven preheated to 400 degrees, so I'm going to mix up a little flavorful mix and put it over the top, and then it will be roasted in the oven. We're going to start with this little bowl and put in 3 tablespoons of olive oil. This is extra virgin olive oil. And then since this is going to be Mexican style, I've chosen some Mexican type flavors. I have 1 teaspoon of chili powder. That can be any brand that you like. They're going to taste different depending on the brand that you get, but it's going to give you a nice hot taste that you will recognize as Mexican. Now I have ground cumin seed, 1 teaspoon of that. And next comes oregano, 1 teaspoon of oregano. So these are my flavors, and if you think that that's going to be too powerful for you, then cut the flavors in half. You can keep your olive oil, 3 tablespoons, but just do 1/2 teaspoon of each of the chili powder, ground cumin seed, and the oregano. But I'm using 1 teaspoon of each of those. And then just whisk this until you get it all blended. And then pour it over the garbanzo beans. So you want to do this in such a way that you get them coated pretty well, but we will try to disperse that a little bit. I have my flavorings pretty well dispersed over the garbanzo beans. You can see it's covering them really well. And what I want to do is season these with salt and pepper. So I'm just taking some sea salt and I'm grinding it over the top. It will not be a lot. You generally want a salty snack to munch on, but I don't want to overdo it because it would not be good if it were too salty. And some people kind of watch the amount of salt they use too. And then some ground pepper. So I'm just freshly grinding these black peppercorns over the top. Just a light dusting will be fine. And then stir that in. And then we want them back to one layer. So let's just kind of shake this back and forth in both directions. And you may need to use your spatula a little bit as well. And that's good enough. It doesn't have to be perfect. This is going to a 400 degree oven, and it's going to be about a half hour that it takes. I will be watching it and I will be stirring it occasionally. And then you'll see the product when it's finished. Our Mexican-style garbanzo beans are done. I just got them from the oven where I baked them for 45 minutes at 400 degrees. That sounds like a lot, but these were very soft when we started out and they were puffed up a little bit because of the moisture they contained. You can see they have compacted and they are smaller. And right now they're so hot that they're still a little bit soft, but as they cool down, they will become more crispy. But you may serve them hot or at room temperature. So I'm going to go ahead and put these in a serving dish or serving bowl. I have one right here, actually with these being so much smaller, it's just going to make a little inch around the bottom or something like that, but we'll go with that. Our Mexican-style roasted garbanzo beans would be great for a party of some type. And since it's close to the Super Bowl, you might want to use it as a dish that you serve at the Super Bowl. You might want to double the recipe because you can see what we have here will not go a long way when you have a crowd of people. I would suggest that you double it and put two pans in the oven if you have two pans. If not, just one after the other. You can do them and they're not much trouble to do. You have to wait on them for that 45 minutes while they bake. As far as serving them, this is a finger food, which you may eat with your fingers, but if a lot of people are going to be eating, you probably would rather serve it out on some kind of little plate like this, or it could be a larger plate, but I'm just going to take my little serving here. And I'm going to use my fingers to eat it. It's still hot, so it's not going to be quite as crunchy as it will be later on. But it's crunchy enough. It's a really good flavor. I could even take more of that flavor. Although I would say this is just kind of medium level of heat. I could go on, but there's no need of that. I'll tell you, they are really good. And if you want to substitute for your salty snack, which might be potato chips or Dorito chips, Fritos, or something like that, this will be a lot healthier. And I think you'll really enjoy it.